Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Map 2 for Fluxo versus INTZ is upon us. It is Boggs and Pineapple Phillips on the microphone for us all. And well, the buy is interesting. We have the dualies for Dash. The dualies seem to be a common thing in South America. And we do have a much more common buy, P250 Super Soldier, two sets of utility for Fluxo on the T side.
No kit for INTZ on their defense. It is Fluxo's map pick of Inferno. 16-10 the victory for INTZ on Ancient, their own pick, map number one. History probing up towards brackets. No aggressive peek from INTZ. Bob's around the corner. Dash up in halls with those dual Berettas. So lets it fly and does finish off VSM as his teammate falls. Lub has to retreat to the bomb site, but the B split is open for Fluxo now. They can wrap their way into B. They can try and go through library, but they are going to go for a bit of a B wrap. Leo getting forced away. He will escape into church. He will claim sanctuary, and W1 will cover his retreat with a three-piece of one taps. He taps away. He gets them all. And Lukauzi, what's he going to do now? He's got nothing in terms of a teammate. He's got nothing in terms of utility. He's got no bomb. He's got a backstab to deal with. And it's Dash on the dualies to do him in. Pistol round converted. Very clean by INTZ.
A very solid start. I had a lot of questions coming into this one. Fluxo didn't look like they had any protocols or any clear strats in mind on their opponent's map pick of Ancient, but I thought certainly it would be a different affair on map 2 of Inferno. We still have a lot of map to go, but INTZ at the very least looking comfortable and looking to make this as difficult as possible for the favored Fluxo squad. No nonsense play, just aggression down middle with rifles, of all things, against the pistols. I was going to let that one simmer for a moment because I thought it might get zesty with the rifles pressing it down, but that's clearly not the case. It's a very quick fold of the Fluxo squad, a clean and flawless victory, and now we get to see the bonus round, round number 3. Fluxo have rifles across the board. They're lacking a little bit in utility because they did not get a bomb plant in either of the prior two rounds, but they do have an advantage against Bob's and Leo Monster, who have a FAMAS and an MP9 respectively.
I do have the advantage, but INTZ should not be running it down mid again. They did get a little lucky, though, I will say, because if they were up against a force buy, it would have ended probably significantly differently for INTZ on the aggression down mid. Either way, though, they had a nice clean mop-up, they had a kill party, and now they can get back into the swing of things here. Dash, nice little spray away onto Lukauzi. And Dash will double down onto Woody, doing good work with the rifle in hand, flashing himself into brackets, going for a peek, spots out history, has to reload into the open. VSM will finally put him down, end the menace. Phelps, in the meantime, creeping up towards B, bomb down T, ramp as of now, a minute to go in this round. And no real ground for Fluke, so they will recover the bomb, but Phelps has been spotted. The target zone is relatively well known. And even if they go back the way of A, still players down and waiting for it. So INTZ, they should be able to lock this one down. It's about minimizing the casualties at this point. Not letting these kills go the way of Fluke. So utility, doing a little bit of chip damage, buying time. W1 around has to be careful. That's why he has to be careful. A bit of undue aggression coming through from the lad.
Speaking of, Phelps got cheeky all the way around towards ET spawn. Off some bullets, though. Giveaway position and fell back. Phelps, timing's everything. It's just not in his favor there. He will survive. Team flashing. CT side. They line up a bit. Phelps finds one. Not the second. Good trade from Lub, but Drund has been costly. ESM, this is a very doable one versus two. He's hiding in towards dark. Leo Monster's pressing that MP9 up close. Is very scary. Position's known. Dink and taken down. Combined fire from the two. Does yield a third for INTZ, but that round got much more expensive and much closer than it should have.
Yeah, definitely much more expensive, much closer. A bit of over-aggression from INTZ when they didn't need to peek. And things almost get a little bit rougher for them. So they are lucky to get away with a win there. That could have been a lot worse. It'll be a buy-up again for Fluxo, given the fact that they did get the bomb down. Op out for Dash now. I'm excited to see how he wants to play CT op on Inferno. Would love to see some aggression from him. He's been great with the rifle, as evidenced before. Good on the pistols. He's not really missed too many op shots we've seen against Luke, so at least on Ancient. And nades in towards Banana. Gonna do a little bit of damage onto Woody, down to about half. As Fluxo, giving up most of their A control, taking the Banana control instead, which has been ceded over to them by INTZ.
I don't think INTZ have challenged Banana too much, necessarily. It's part of the plan. Good harassing utility as well. They will throw the retake utility, not explicitly use it, but slowly chipping away at Fluxo's health. Fluxo will regain control, but INTZ are reading this pretty well. Setting up for more utility. Going to be a straight pop play over towards B. Spam doesn't connect from W1. His player on site now is on an island. Leo Monster just spamming the smoke, desperately hoping to find a kill. No such luck. Phelps jumping over finds one. Good trade from W1, who will fall back, happy with the even footing going into the retake. The issue is VSM pressed towards tree, finds one. Tags a second W1, stuck between a rock and a hard place. Can't find the kills. And INTZ, it seems like they should have had that read. It was a very transparent, almost desperate play from Fluxo. Well, they don't rotate anybody over, and they get caught out by the aggression. Fluxo do get on the board, but INTZ, at the very least, will get to save a pair of rifles.
He'll save the AK and the M4, a bit of utility as well, but I agree. That was a round which was telegraphed heavily by Fluxo. They threw in calling card after calling card, and still nothing got done. Nothing was read into it by INTZ. And a little overzealous in the spams, perhaps, too, trying to catch him off guard, when in fact that just ended up being the undoing of INTZ. One kill, maybe two kills coming through from the spam on from oranges, and that's a different round instead of just a plain save. So, Fluxo, they take advantage of some less than adequate reads from INTZ, and they run rampant with it. It's going to be a buy-up again from the CT side, of course. But Fluxo, they have an opportunity to build up some rounds, build up some money, get back in this game, in this series, more importantly, and look to win their first map of this tournament. It's an elimination game, folks. Loser of this best of three will not qualify for IEM Dallas.
Ooh!
And Boss is down middle. Make sure Woody can't do anything, but history trades him down the aggression. It only works for one, and INTZ come out behind the early engagements.
I like the idea, but execution wasn't quite so good. The issue for me in the last round wasn't that there was a bad read, it was that there was no read. They didn't get aggressive, they didn't operate off of the lack of information. W1 on towards B, though. Up close and personal is in a one-and-done spot, and the issue is he has no backup on the site to work with. He only finds his one, then he's done. As is the round. 2 versus 3, not worth it in the retake. Lukauzi already on an aggressive hunt, has one. Probably the second as well. He'll line up the first, finds it. Not the second, but he'll survive. Lub, here towards the apartments, is going to save the AK. Maybe he'll go back for the op, but as it stands, it's just the rifle.
Nate,
second on the board for Fluxo. Uh-oh. What is the stat?
INTZ's CT side win rate on Inferno. We'll wait and see if Lub gets out of here alive first.
He's going
for the op. History's on the hunt for him, but... Oh my gosh, Lub. Wow! He actually wins that and gets the op. That's clutch. That's
does he
big.
Get the op? Is a player hunting? Okay, he does survive. That was big. Well, it got close, but that was a costly round for Fluxo as well.
Very. But here's the stat, Nate. INTZ's CT side win rate on Inferno. 34.8%.
Really?
34.8%.
That's 1 in 3, so right now we're over halfway to the
there.
Par. Yeah,
they're
well, no,
par,
5.
Practically. Oh, yeah.
Five is par. Yeah. We're not playing short matches here, Boggs.
True. Who knows? CS2 might be MR12.
Don't say that. Don't say that. They tested it.
I was part of that test. I did not enjoy it.
From the wrong community. Okay. ESM. Out the balcony again. These contact plays from Fluxo are working out. They spot the pistols. No respect. Dash, though, with the op finds two. W1 chimes in with the USP. The round's at the very least costly, if not disastrous. But history lines up, too. Woody is low. But that double might be what saves Fluxo. That lineup for history. Leo Monster rotating around, has an AK, but is more inclined to save this, or at least go for some safer exits towards the apartments. INTZ did well to find the damage, but Fluxo are finding their groove. Their no respect aggression, their pop plays are beginning to find footing.
I would also like to add that Fluxo's T side is 59.1%.
I don't know what the CTZ stats for them are and what the TZ stats are.
7 for Fluxo on CT.
Fluxo are just good on both sides.
And for INTZ on T side, 50.9.
That's a pretty good stat line, actually, for their T side, given their.
That's not bad for T. It's their CT side, which is kind of abysmal.
And you need to keep in mind the wins that. The caliber of teams they're beating and they're facing are not crazy.
The
I mean, their wins are against the Union, Boku
the best.
Exactly. And, you know, we just saw them play this map versus 0-0 Nation, and you know what the score was there, Bugs?
Was that the 16-1?
Yeah, it wasn't the 16-3, it was the 16-1. Either case would have been bad, let's be honest,
yeah.
But it was the worst of the two. Phelps, while blind, it's a boom. Good trade from Desh, though, and there are still two players towards B. If Fluxo come into the site, could be ugly. Why did Woody have a sawed-off?
That's a very good question. A question I do not have an answer to.
I'm going to go with the term PSYOP like we normally do. I think that was a PSYOP
buy. I'm going to go with jump spot, half wall, get kill, funny.
Funny PSYOP, yeah, exactly.
Yeah. I've never seen the sawed-off. I don't think I've seen the sawed-off at a match of this level, or a match above advanced, since Cobblestone was in the pool.
I say you haven't seen it since Cobblestone. That is the best way to put it. When JW was doing that kind of play, Woody on 1 HP will survive. Site control taken, and man advantage secured. Bomb plant forthcoming. W1. Thinking about spamming, doesn't get any tags, doesn't receive any either. The teammates loving W1 have not moved whatsoever. They're just over towards port side of A. W1 easily isolated. There's no one to support him. He's on an island. He's taken down. But INTZ are so prone to calling saves. Like, it's a 3 versus 4, and you have the opportunity to find one before the bomb plant comes down. At least go CT and support your teammate, for crying out loud.
Yeah. This is giving me, for those of you who watch North American Counter-Strike at least past, like, 3-4 years, you know Sheik Zula's teams on Inferno, they will pretty much save if the site's gone. This is what this is reminding me of right now from INTZ. And how many times do we see those Sheik Zula-led teams end up collapsing under the weight of having to save all the time? A lot. Especially if it was a close game. It would come back to bite them. And I feel like that's coming back to bite INTZ here. Their side holds aren't really doing enough, and the rotations are not there to really support the side hold. Their utility's not there to help stall. It's a bit of a mess for my INTZ, and I would have liked to see a tactical timeout used either into this round or the next. This round, because
it's a half
still buy.
Next round.
Around. Yeah. Although, I don't really feel like you need a timeout to fix what's going wrong. I feel like it's pretty elementary.
Yeah, it doesn't feel like Fluxo are giga-braining their way through this. It feels like they're winning their fights, and INTZ are playing a little bit too passive. A little bit out of their element, I think is the best way to put it.
Too passive at certain moments and too aggressive at the wrong moments. Like, they're
Fair.
Trying to hold the sights by wide swinging the flashbangs. And it's just, or like that. Like that. Like, just early peaks coming through. It's one and done. And you don't even get the one. It's all over. W1's going to do what
Ooh.
He can. Walks into the open. This cannot be a save from INTZ. This hat. Are you kidding
the
me?
The 2v2. Are you kidding me? 2v2. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Get that confidence up, fellas.
But,
come on.
No, now you got to save because you took too long to go. If they would have gone instantly, they could have had it. But they wait, they hesitate. Hesitation is a killer.
It seems like they're really paranoid about a lurk. We've seen, like, late apartments players catch players on rotation towards brackets, stuff along those lines. So you can see someone hanging around for that kind of reality, but in actuality, there's no such play coming through. Fluxo have just been committing their players to the site, getting a little bit aggressive in towards CT spawn because no one's rotating, and then having the victory from that. INTZ have made a couple. I would love to see him force the issue, but I know it's not the responsible call. He'll find one. Dash, though, doesn't get a rifle. We'll at least have the op here. Do we see a tactical pause? Do we at least see something from this save fiasco, is the best way to put it.
I need a tac pause. I need the tac pause out of INTZ here. Come on. I don't like this at all. This is... INTZ are their own worst enemy right now.
They aren't challenging Banana time. Again. Actually, they are, but they're not, like, pressing down, you know?
Yeah.
Slow. They're just... It's unfortunate. And this play with only two players on A is very risky.
And they're double stacked towards... Are they double? Oh, it's a top hut and bottom hut. They're the top porch, bottom porch.
With only two players on A, it's over.
Oh my. They only get one out of that, too?
Like, even if they get three, it's an empty A bomb site and it's a retake. Like, oh god, we're seeing another save, man.
All right. Can we just go to nuke already at this point?
Can we get, like, two tactical pauses back-to-back? We need to talk this out, guys.
Yeah.
If you're going to go aggressive, do it on one site and not both. They got aggressive top banana with three players. That means you don't go aggressive A. You don't go passive necessarily because you want to get the info a little bit earlier, but you don't want to fold when you're both playing like that. That kind of stack only works when you have a third player watching the apartments to trade out your teammates towards truck side as well. It's the only time it works.
Or you have somebody arch who can...
But even then, if you're going to stack up two on porch, you want to triple stack towards truck side. Sure, they didn't get exploited from the apartments that round, but it's the only responsible way, I would say, to hold that double porch setup.
Yep. And the fact they're both playing anti-flash and only get one kill out of it.
It's crazy.
Not good enough. Quite simple. Was having a conversation with a North American coach last night. He's like, yeah, you know, it's a crazy concept, but sometimes you just need to hit him in the head to win a game of Counter-Strike. And that's kind of what Fluxo are doing right now. They're just hitting him in the head, and it's working. And it's something that Fluxo have not been able to do this whole time. Desh will shut down Woody on a very early brackets run, which was unsupported by pretty much anything. He's just kind of going for a dry fight up bracket, and he gets punished for it. Aggression banana again, and this time it's not going to be aggression from INTZ towards A as well. Let's see if they can hold off the line. W1 playing anti. The peak's coming in dry from Phelps. The push is coming through. Utility being used. W1 not cleared. He's blinded. He gets one. Leo trades it out onto history. Bomb drops in towards sandbags around the circle. BSM wins that fight 3v2. Oh boy, Bob just goes in and gives them the next kill. Fluxo knocking on the door of a seventh round, although they have pumped the brakes here. Dash is off, has rotated in. Lub holding in towards... Oh, miss from Dash. That's going to allow the bomb to go down. And do INTZ save again? Surely they don't save here. Surely they go for it.
If Lub goes down, the op saves.
Well, at that point, it has to.
Yeah. Split up again is not something I like here. Nice off angle from the cows. He finds the kill. But Desh gets the trade. Okay. Desh gets the trade. He'll go for it. 1v1. Throws the smoke. Tries to get ahead of it. Spam the smoke desperately. He's dead. There's no way. Oh, he gets the 180. Never mind. Desh gets a boon. A gift of a round. And INTZ do finally put a fourth on the board. That is... There's no world where that should happen. 15 kills for Desh. Boggs, I need to highlight as well. You said that Fluxo are just hitting heads and winning rounds. Prior to this round, not the top frag, not the two top frags, but the top three players in the server were on INTZ. So it's not that Fluxo are getting the kills outright. It's the fact that Fluxo are getting the kills so quickly, opening up a site and forcing the save. All of the kills that INTZ are getting feel inconsequential. They're on the hunting players.
Yep.
So if INTZ can just adjust accordingly, actually play more consequential spots, play more together, then we have a different situation on our hands. Then we see a team that can actually go toe-to-toe. Because right now, INTZ are punching above their weight class. They are winning the duels. They just have to win them in a consequential location.
Like what Desh did.
Exactly what Desh did.
Wasn't quite hitting him in the head, but it had the same result.
It's a 4-stack A.
Yeah. And there's no stall utility on Leo.
He had stall utility. And he has a smoke still.
You have a second player. Bob's has come.
Thank goodness. But still, it's the two players that are actually struggling on this B site. Leo Monster and Bob's. Mm-hmm. And they're making the reach at the wrong time. Now the pressure's at A. Oh, no. As they rotate a third player over in W1. It's INTZ just making the wrong reads. The lurking player towards apartments will be unseated. Good shot from Dash. He takes a lot of damage. Love getting a timing onto a second shore. That's nice. But he's stuck in. Phelps finds the trade. Advantage remains, but Dash is on an island. That AUG has to come in quickly to support.
A Molotov pretty much kills Dash here. He gets flushed into the open. He's got no HP. He's got to get a dry fight win. Bob's might just peek in. He catches timing onto Lukauzi. Transitions over to Phelps and takes the second player down. Dash with another tag onto history. His op is ringing true. Not quite the kill is through the wall, but it works out the same. The damage is done. One HP on both Fluxo players alive. One HP essentially. I mean, not technically, but effectively. And they're going to save here. Now it's the T side forced to save. Dash with a big kill. Bob's coming in with that good spray down and the tag. And then Love. He got that kill on Apps, backed away. Fluxo. Starting to slide a little bit. INTZ, getting more rounds on the board.
They're forcing the issue more. That's what I like. Mm-hmm. They press in the apartments. They found one and two. Sure, the player got traded eventually over towards the boiler side, but still, they emerged with the advantage. And Dash is having a heck of a series thus far. Granted, a lot of his kills have been exits, right? They saved a majority of the rounds that they've lost. He is getting kills nonetheless, and that is good for the confidence of your team. 16 kills for him, might I add, at the start of round 12. INTZ already have their requisite number of rounds expected from their stats. That was 34% win rate on CT side. They have 5. That is math checking out. But they want more than that. I would say 7 or 8 would be ideal, given Fluxo's success on this map.
Phelps is dead. Flashed, mollied, roasted. Barbecue Phelps up. And Bob's, destroyed by Lukauzi, actually opens up the round for Fluke. So if Bob's gets even one more, it gives a lot more possibility to INTZ. Love around the smoke. Spots one over the hay cart, but VSM and Lukauzi open up A. Dash is sitting on B. W1 creeps through, and he gets punished. And Fluxo back to their fast-paced headshotting ways. Bust open the A site. Keep the lead in their hands. A great way to get back into this one.
Timing after timing for Lukauzi.
Yeah.
He does, but I have to say, Fluxo should be, I don't want to say less voraciously hunting because it definitely does help to drop the op, but they've lost so much economy. Like, they won 6 rounds in a row. They have next to nothing in the bank because they've hunted so aggressively and they haven't had any success. Dash has been unreal on the exits. He will successfully survive. 4 players will survive for Fluxo as well. CT side, they will get another buy on the board. The Opera can drop one of his teammates. Everybody else should be able to invest. It should be a solid buy, but again, INTZ have not instilled confidence. Their CT setups have been uninspired and even misguided at certain points. We have to see an adjustment from them, or at least a good read from them. Because if not, it's going to be Fluxo continuing to win rounds, especially if Lukauzi can hit the shots like he did in that round prior. Aggression,
flashing
banana.
In, W1 pushing Leo with the opening kill. W1 still alive. Bob's actually doubles down. W1's the one to fall. The mana doesn't fire a shot. Dash catches history, and Lukauzi retreats back to recover the bomb, which is stranded bottom ramp. Dash lets another one fly. Can't quite get the win against Lukauzi just yet, but it seems that INTZ are about to hit 6. There is the flank around from Lub onto Lukauzi. Fluxo had a good round response, but they get murdered in the next. The banana aggression from INTZ, the proactivity works. leaving Dash to just probe up towards middle. Let the op take the mid peak. Let the rifles push down banana as it should be. Well done from INTZ. Good utility support as well. W1 just got a little unlucky as the one to fall, but overall, it's a good response from INTZ and Flukeso. Back on a buy again, but as you mentioned, they're money in the bin because of how voraciously they've hunted. Two Galils, three AKs, only two Molotovs. What's the call from Flukeso?
What is the call? It's a great question. They do have the utility to continue their aggressive playstyle. They have two Galils, as you mentioned, on Woody and Phelps, which makes things awkward. It will still one-shot headshot 20% of the INTZ squad. One player without that head armor, that's a Dash the Opper. INTZ back to a more standard default 2B3A. Leo aggressing towards banana is alone on an island, jumping around, and Phelps exploits that reality. The Galil finds the headshot and the kill. That is an advantage secured. INTZ now feeling uncomfortable, are now aggressing towards the brackets, hoping to be gifted a kill in response, but no. Flukeso are grouping up. They're going to go B, and they are making the right read once again.
Flukeso's reads have been so well done. INTZ taking a lot of baits and just Gamble stacking a lot of different areas. W1 doing good to try and stall, but he's on an island. He's got no help. He's got minimal utility here. He'll try and stop a plant, but he's going to get a little bit of chip damage and get all but sprayed down to death. And, well, Nate, it looks like it's going to be another one of those things called saves.
Yeah, those two players seem to be rooted towards the truck side. Time and time again. And again, I hate to see it. 4 versus 5, if you just press down middle or at least look for a player lurking and then go from there, it can be a very different story. It took Flukeso a long time to plant that bomb.
Yeah, if you even rotate one guy to CT, they might not even get the bomb down.
Or you can get one as they're planting, in which case it becomes far more manageable.
Yeah.
They're too proactive in the saves.
Two players CT, two players bananas. It's a split to B. You have utility. You don't need a full commit, but at least send some pressure towards it.
Six to eight, though. INTZ trailing by two. The beauty of a save, though, is that you really don't have to worry about the economy too much. You can easily invest. I think Dash will probably have his op. There it is. It was on the ground. So full rifles, full utility, kits, armor. Everything that the CT side could need. Same story for Flukeso, though. The victory, they have full utility, AKs across the board, Kevlar helmets. It's an even buy going into the final round of this first half.
Dash has to be careful not to get caught. It's a sprint up brackets from Flukeso. Dash still scoped in. He hears them all running. He sees them all passing. He catches history off. That's a nice start. But in towards Speedway, Lukowski domes Bob's. Lub just going to hang in towards Graveyard. Stairs, bide his time and stop a plant. A very good sneaky play they need. He's going to spot the player in towards apartments as well. But W1 falls in the interim. Lub stuck in a... out in the open, he's gone down. Leo, 1v3, not to be. Lukowski puts him down. It's a 9-6 half in the favor of Flukeso on their own map pick. We'll see you for half number two.
An uninspired first half from INTZ leads them to a deficit, but not an irrecoverable one. 6-9, Pineapple Phillips and Boggs on the microphone. And INTZ, what is their T-side? Will it be something with more flair, more inspiration, more zest, or will it be more of the same disillusioned, slow, and scared? Double dualies for the CT side. Dispatched one pair, at the very least, very early on. Two kills going unanswered from Bobs and Leo Monster, two of the players we want to see more from, and that is the best start they could ask for. Bomb plant on the A site, and a very difficult 3-5 proposition ahead of Flukeso at the start of the second half.
That was ugly. That was ugly. And VSM's just opened the door back in here. What?
And more of the same, baby. More of the same. Back to saves.
No, he's setting up util. He's setting up util, I think.
No.
No?
History's gone. Oh, he's saving utility and the kit for the following. And VSM is going to go raid boss mode on the way out.
Whoa. Imagine if they would have gone with two and not wasted 10 seconds.
Jesus Christ, VSM.
Wonder what would have happened if they would have actually gone for the round, huh?
DSM has flawless Kevlar, so he's going to lose it. But Lub is going to lose his life with the bomb. VSM does it all. It's 4 kills and the 5th by the bomb. And again, these saves called time and time again by the CT side of both INTZ and Flukeso are going to drive me insane.
Be driven insane, so hop along, get on the bus. Go insane together.
Is that 4 pistols for INTZ as well? 4-4? I hate to put you on the spot like that. I think it is,
they
though.
They lost one on Ancient, I thought.
I'm going to go check. I'm going to go do the math.
I feel like they lost first pistol Ancient. No, wait, no. Not first pistol, second pistol. But don't quote me.
They lost second pistol. Wait, no, they won second pistol. Crazy.
Did they not lose a... Well...
I think they've lost a pistol.
They're losing this! They're losing this! They're losing to a CZ and an M4! They're getting mopped up! INTZ! They walk in dry, they get punished! And now they're trying to get back into the B side of things. VSM's holding the line with a solo deagle. Phelps goes aggressive, he gets hunted. And Lob and Bobs go down! Leo won on a parting gift. He's spammed by a 5-7. This map is sheer pandemonium.
Chaos, pandemonium. Upending any and every expectation you might have. I just checked. As far as I can tell, sometimes the graphics are hard to read in the in-progress games, but as far as I can tell, INTZ are 4-4 on pistol rounds. The issue is they don't convert this one.
Yeah, big issue. And that's because they just try to go dry fight and Flukeso forced.
And now they're going to rifles. It's against a force, but it's a very audacious call, but it has worked out thus far. Bukowski finding one, History a second, third almost. W1 actually eventually finds one before being caught falling away, and that's the bomb drop. Player underpass not long for the world, and okay, Lukowski spamming the smoke. He's going to give himself a little clip, finding the fourth in the round for himself. Shoots the gun right by his teammate. That's unfortunate, but it doesn't matter. Flukeso are still in the driver's seat, ahead by 4 and 5 away from closing out their own map pick.
Or decider if we do get all the way there. And Flukeso's nuke from earlier was not exactly inspiring. They didn't get a chance to play Inferno in their first series. But maybe chance for redemption here. INTZ on Glocks this time. Flukeso should have a free 12th. History is on nothing but a USP. Artillery strike down middle, waited out by INTZ. MP9 and AK will grab a couple kills. SMG getting another. Phelps will tap away for a third. He'll steal the money from the SMGs, but Flukeso will grab a 12th round in the end. That's all that really matters. And INTZ have to buy up here and now. They have to stop the bleeding. They have to build something into this map, or they will be done sooner rather than later. Galil, AKs, decent amount of utility, all things considered, although a little bit lacking in the Molotov department. Flukeso, VSM better have a gun. Okay, he does. I was gonna say, he better not be on a tech knife. He's got an M4. That SMG of Woody cannot be understated either because it is Inferno. Close range angle, mow down a player, grab an AK. Different story.
How's the aggression in the apartments already? would be expected. W1 walking up. He's not going to win this direction, is he? He does. He does win the duel as well. That's important. Lukowsky is very quick with his headshots. Not to be this time around. Phelps will find a trade, sure. But 4v4 favors the T's. Leo Monster over towards B is heating up. Finds the player top towards car. But Phelps in the apartments has been a harassing presence. Laid down his teammate history. 63. But Lub in the apartments does finally unseat Phelps. History middle is spotted, taken down. INTZ finally finding something, finally exploiting Fluxo's aggression. It's just VSM. He was a very hot commodity on on series number one, I should say, but cannot answer the call in the 1v3. Lub finds the kill. And INTZ do secure the first rifle round of half number two. The question is, can they maintain any sort of momentum from this? Can they find rounds consistently? Fluxo still look like a menace on the CT side.
Turning it together, though. They can't just keep getting rounds on islands. Neither team. Still danger zone for Fluxo. They can still definitely let this one slide away. INTZ knocking on the door of something of a comeback, but a lot more work to do to actually make it closer. Four rounds, decent golf. Phelps does not get distracted by the chicken. Teammate joins him. Lub might have been hurt. Phelps is peeking. Nice shot by Lub. But Lukowsky there for the trade. Still trade should favor the T side. Need pressure from Leo as well. Woody getting around that Molotov. Leo flashed in. Woody's dead to rights. VSM out towards Coffin. Has to be careful not to be put in one here. Peeks out. Spots one. Leo done. Bob's not able to trade just yet. Utility coming through. Just good amount of stall by VSM. Throwing flashes and such. Just hanging around being a nuisance. Spam the peak. And he goes down to dash. But history trades. Bob's your uncle on the history. Lukowsky's the last man alive. Caught up by W1. And INTZ two in a row now. Fluxo not going to be able to buy up. Maybe a bit of a half buy from Lukowsky and Woody. But everybody else should be pretty much on a save. A chance for INTZ to grab double digits. Close to within two. And work on this T side here. Lukowsky going all in. Is Fluxo going to force up here?
Doesn't seem like it. Maybe the hero rifle with pistol surrounding. I think we saw this as well in their first series versus 9Z. Lukowsky going for the hero rifle. Yeah, it was on Mirage. Remember, they kind of scaled out A site. No holds barred. Caution to the wind. And they actually won that round. So, good workout here and now. But the CT side is a very different situation than the T side of Mirage. Can't really just press out into a site and go from there. You have to hold more measured. It's a B stack from Fluxo. They've done away with the aggression. It has been called out by INTZ. They're instead stacking up on a site. Two towards CT, two towards Dark. It's Molotov, though. Actually, it's towards the box. It's not towards the back site. So this rifle of Lukowsky could have tremendous impact on this take.
Lukowsky up on top. Spots out the first, deals with the first. Woody trying to flash in. Lukowsky gets the second as Woody falls. 4v3 to the favor of Fluxo and INTZ starting to pump the brakes here. Kind of smelling a stack, but Lukowsky up on top of Dark makes it a... He's got
an ace.
He's on for the ace. He's aced it out. He just pick up one by one. He's not deterred. No utility to force him off. Brilliant play by Lukowsky. And Fluxo have ripped one away from INTZ, who now... Half their players are broke.
I don't know how the one player hero rifling with four pistols surrounding works with such tremendous constancy, but it works. Second time now today. Lukowsky. I said it would be hard for him to put up a stand-up performance on the CT side, but INTZ are more than happy to give it to him. All five players walk into the angle, more or less one by one as well, might I add. Just like they were flummoxed. They were at a loss as to where Lukowsky was lurking. Just walked into the angle, thinking he would be in a different spot. INTZ will scrounge together a buy as best they can. Two Galils, two pistols, and an AK. They're lacking utility. And more importantly, it seems like they're lacking a direction. They will finally snake their way up the banana. BSM is here spamming away. There's so much damage finding one and tagging two down incredibly low. Woody as well lurking around is more than eager, more than ready to find more. He'll find a second. Five from INTZ is falling flat. Woody up close will finally be unseated, but Still a tremendous advantage for Fluxo. They're already rotating a player over to support this B site.
Molly through to buy more time as there's two players make it a third as Phelps is making his... never mind. Phelps will go to brackets instead, but be a fast rotation towards B should the need arise, which it should. In a moment, Lub leading the charge on towards the B site, peeking around VSM in the back corner. Lub through the smoke, actually slipping into CT spawn. I like this call. Oh no, he's showing a thing, maybe? No, X-ray betrays me. But it will not betray Lub. Bob's caught by history. That's a lapse in judgment from Bob's. As VSM catches off Lub. Dash, nothing he can really do here. Flicks up, goes down. 14-9, Fluxo, two away from sending us to our first map three of the day.
Two away. 14-9, and I would say Fluxo definitely deserve it. They have looked like the better squad across the board, especially on their T side. INTZ looked uninspired on the CT side of the equation, looking less than ideal on the T side as well. And at this point, they're capitulating that 15th. They're playing for overtime. It's just Glocks, not a penny invested for INTZ. And at this point, I would say the bomb plant is a distant dream in a round like this.
A distant dream. Almost an impossible dream. A little bit of a one-way thrown for Phelps to be able to get some kills. Silent boost attempted, but Phelps is watching for it. He'll get the free first onto Lub. Reload and back away. Look for more. Has help from middle. Flashed in towards the angle. Nade will do a little bit of team damage, but he'll continue to push on down. Dash. Waiting. He was the man who boosted up his teammates. Kind of just hoping something happens to give him a window out. He gets caught by VSM, though. Bombed down. Lugalzi around towards Apps. Might actually get caught here. He'll do one bit of catching. He'll get both. Make it all
part of the Glock. I think the Glock just walked into his hands, just showed through the smoke. That was so awkward. Even if that player allowed the smoke to fade and had a complete blindsight on him, it's a Glock against the helmet. It takes like three headshots. It's not going to get
that
it.
Range, it's two.
Is it two? Okay. Well, even then, I don't think he gets it. It's going to be close because the aim punch will just throw him off. An attack pause called. That's finally range. Attack pause. That's the first one used by INTZ. I'm not sure that attack pause here would have, or in the series, or this map, I should say, would have helped too much. It feels like they're just being outstratted. It feels like they don't have a book deep enough or setups and redundancies and protocol setup that are deep enough to handle the likes of Fluxo.
I agree. It looks like INTZ's out of their depth on this map. And Fluxo, they've definitely made up for their transgressions previously. Lukauzi having a good game. VSM as well. VSM's been solid all evening. I will say that. He's been very good. But Fluxo now, they need a little bit more. They need someone to eke out this 16th round and try and eliminate INTZ. Have a rematch with 9Z potentially, or a matchup against 00 Nation. Loser of that series will await the winner of this one. In the consolidation final, and the winner of that plays in the grand final, all of that tomorrow. Lub, peeking around, looking for a pick from Apps, down at a boiler, goes back up. Double stack porch. It's a four stack A from Fluxo, Nate. Two arch side, two porch side. It's a collapse towards this angle. And INTZ are gonna walk into the jaws of the beast.
Three players. One arch, two towards the porch. Lukauzi takes down two. He's been on a heater this series. He's approaching 30. Three versus five for W1, Desh, and Leo Monster. It just doesn't seem possible. Desh doesn't even have his characteristic big green up. ESM is still... Actually, he's bolstered this defense. He's rotated around at the perfect time. Much to the chagrin of INTZ, or trying to walk in desperately. Good flash is blind Woody, but he doesn't fire too early. He will get caught, and W1 does find the second onto VSM. That support means nothing, as they are both dispatched rather easily. Three versus three going into the retake. It is still doable for the CT side, but it has become a little bit more worrisome. Good nade in onto Leo. Monster good flash as well, but Leo avoids it. He finds the headshot, not the second. Good trade from Phelps back to even footing. 2v2. Dash on the back of sight. Spams away. Does eventually connect onto one. It leaves just Lukauzi, the heavy hitter, in the clutch. 1v2. Bomb's halfway gone. At this point, he's playing for exits. He wants to make the next round following all the more easier. And I have to say, this is the right call. Make both players fall by the bomb's hands? No. Could have found some exits, but they line up. They combine fire. W1 and Desh do keep INTZ alive. The question is, can they find more than one?
And they call an instant timeout on the back of that as well. Because that wasn't a very smooth round. That was one they were lucky to win. So they're going back into it. They're going back in with another timeout. They're going to try and attempt to bring this one back. It would require 6 rounds in a row for overtime for INTZ. Double ops have been called into play by Fluxo. VSM holding on to the secondary. A MAC-10 for Bobs. Far from an ideal weapon. Another thing to note, 9 kills separating number one and number two on INTZ right now. 9.
And keep in mind, Desh only got all those kills on exits.
Yep.
Like, all of those kills come from exits on the CT side. He was at, what, 16 by the start of round 12?
Something around that's there.
Six kills in 13 rounds, if I'm doing the math correctly. So, a remarkable cooling off. Leo, though, wants to make that round something more than a flash in the pan, finds the opening. But Woody with the nade finds a trade onto the dash, and VSM with the op catches Leo jumping around. Manage swings back to Fluxo's favor. Phelps furthers it over towards the graveyard. He'll find one spot, a second, and a third. Won't get the kill, but he has the information. Club is on a sliver of HP. 3v2, double up in the retake. Might be unwieldy, but it should still be doable for Fluxo.
VSM backing away. Peeking out, flashbang well timed. No plan just yet for INTZ. Wall bang from VSM, a spam from W1, can't quite counter. Fake plant, nobody peeking through that smoke. History going around the long way. And W1 taking another fake plant. History still creeping around through brackets, going for a truck side flank. W1 finally plants the bomb, but he's stuck. There's nowhere for him to go. They line up, they jump across, he spots them out. He spots out both. He knows where they are, but history's no scope from the side will shut down W1 and INTZ's chances here in map number two. That means we go to Nuke, Nate. That means we get our first third map series in this tournament so far. And that means Fluxo have a chance to close it out with a reverse sweep on a map, which they should definitely have the number of INTZ on.
They definitely should. They also have that momentum.